إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. This is lecture number 10 from the series The Right Beliefs, and it is the second lecture in the second semester, and we could give it the name The Reality of Iman, حقيقة الإيمان. Again, we kinda spoke about this last week, and I believe we were a little bit unsuccessful in presenting the subject to you. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us today and bring the serenity and the sakina so that we understand this important subject. First of all, this we are not talking about the articles of faith. How many articles of faith are there? Six. Believe in Allah, angels, books, messengers, day of resurrection, and qadr. We're not talking about that. This is actually the subject of the rest of the series. But we are talking about the reality of faith. حَقِيقَةُ الْإِيمَانِ. The nature of faith, the concept of faith. And I want to let you know that this subject is so important because it is the first issue the Muslims differed upon. The definition of Iman. What is Iman? What Iman is made of? How do you say this person is a believer and this person is not? What is the minimum that you must have in order to be called a believer? And what are the things which you do not have? Then you're not a believer. And when can you call someone else not a believer? The guidelines. And what is the difference between Iman and Islam? What are the levels of Iman? All of this is a subject that the early Muslims differed upon. But again, this is where you value, you feel the preciousness, قيمة يعني, of قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, ما أنا اليوم عليه وأصحابي. Right here, the way that I am on and my companions is the way. The companions, the Sahaba, and their students never differed on the definition of Iman. قول الإمام البخاري رحمه الله is outstanding when he says, هذا القول أخرجه الإمام اللالكائي بسنده, يعني اللالكائي في كتابه رحمه الله, in his book he compiled the statement of البخاري with a chain of narration. البخاري says, لقيت ألف رجل من علماء الأنصار. I have met 1,000 scholars across earth from the ulama of the sunnah, from the follower of the sahaba, none of them differed regarding the definition of iman to be قول وعمل يزيد وينقص. Faith is sayings, action increases and decreases. The fact that I am saying that the first subject, the Ummah, differed upon, but they differed from the ijma'. You understand? This does not justify that they differed, because we have the source. We have the source, and that is, again, I stress, that is why you must strive to take your deen, your religion, your beliefs from that generation, the Sahaba and their students. لو حتى عنهم انسى. If you astray from them, you're going to always find yourself in a different zone, in a way. فالموضوع, the subject is important, and also it is important, in my opinion, to discipline people once it comes to labeling other people. Yani, you cannot imagine that 99.9% of the Muslims do not know this stuff. They do not know it. I mean that. Only few Muslims, and you must be a student of knowledge to be able to grasp that. They know it. The rest of the Muslims, طب ask, what is the definition of iman? يقول له كده, ايه هو عرف لي الايمان, what is iman? We'll hear so many things. This subject is important to also discipline us, not to become judgmental, not to become mean, not to be more motivated to label other people, rather try to educate them and help them, and help them understand what you understood. Teach them. لأن مسألة التكفير بين المسلمين موجودة. The issue that you walk around, هو كافر, يقول لك ده كافر, ده منافق. لا يا أخي, لا, هذا يعني انسى هذا الموضوع الآن. Forget this now. أقم عليه الحجة أولا. Establish the evidence against him or her first. Then label him. لكن أنت تكفر رجل جاهل بما يقول, بما يفعل. You're going to label somebody to be a kafir when he doesn't even know what he's doing? Allah doesn't do that. Allah sends a messenger to teach us, to warn us, before he holds us accountable. Also, ya ikhwa, this subject is important because الحظ هذا القول والقول هذا, that statement was made by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Umar, and others. شوف, تعلمنا الإيمان ثم تعلمنا القرآن. We learned what faith is, then we learned the Quran. You see, a big problem when Muslims approach the Quran without knowing what faith is, what iman is. You end up dealing with the book of Allah like intellect, like you're reading a book of theology or a book of philosophy or a book of science or a book of mantiq, logic. How many times you find people speaking about the Quran or taking verses from the Quran, speaking about it like he's speaking about a newspaper, some article he read in the newspaper, because he never learned Iman. He doesn't know what Iman is. He doesn't know what Iman is. Iman, that you have a aqidah regarding this Quran. فالصحابة تعلمنا الإيمان, we learned what Iman is, ثم تعلمنا القرآن, then we learned the Quran. شوف شوف شوف, وإنه سيأتي أقوام يتعلمون القرآن, وهذا نحن والله ولا نخفي هذا. Time will come when other generations after us will come and they will learn the Quran first without learning what Iman is. ما هو, when you read in the Sunnah أن عمر memorized سورة البقرة in 10 years, how do you understand that? يعني عمر was unable to memorize the whole Quran in 7 years like one of the kids now, يعني وعمر هذا ملهم محدث كان بيقول كلام القرآن ينزل زي كلامه, ها؟ How do you understand that statement? إيمان دين القرآن. Learning the definition of the إيمان is important. Today I wanna act like a teacher, and I want you to write, and I'll take my time. And there are certain things that I want you to memorize regarding this subject. Here it is. Meaning of Iman. معنى الإيمان. What is the definition of Iman? When we define something, we define it first linguistically. في اللغة. لفظ الإيمان ده جاي منين في اللغة. Then we look for the technical definition of al-Iman, which is needed for us to carry on. Iman in the language, in the Arabic language, comes from security. Amn.
It is linguistic.
Linguistically. Derives from security. Amn. The word security in Arabic called amn. Which is the opposite. Security is the opposite of what? What is the opposite of security? La 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 la. Give me another word. Fear. Fear. Amn khawf. At'amahum min ju'in. ما هو انت لو قرآنيين, لو القرآن شغال معاك وعلى طول هتشتغل. وآمنهم من اهو the opposite, and he secured them from their fear. اهو, that is number one. يبقى ايه security؟ اهو, و ذكرنا, we mentioned قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, حديث فضالة بن عبيد في سنن ابن ماجة. Look, المؤمن, look at this now, المؤمن من أمنه الناس على أموالهم وأعراضهم. شايف, who is the believer? The one whom the people are secure from him regarding their wealth and their honor. Oh, شايف؟ طيب. Honor. Honor. العرض يعني. That they are not going to go after your family. نعم. Also, الإيمان, ومنها يا إخوة برضو إيه يقول لك إيه, النجوم أمنة السماء, أمنة للسماء. حديث النبي, حديث أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه في صحيح الإمام مسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says the stars are the security for the heaven. These stars are guarding the heaven. How? Anybody knows how? Number one, the jinn, when they go and sneak, they want to listen to the angels like they used to do before the sending of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَنَّا كُنَّا نَقْعُدُ مِنْهَا مَقَاعِدَ لِلسَّمْحِ. That was okay. فَمَنْ يَسْتَمِعِ الْآنَ يَجِدْ لَهُ شِهَابَ الرَّصَدَ. We used in the past to go and sneak and hear what the angels are talking about. And we were secure. But now, when we do this after the sending of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, a shooting star strike us. When you see a shooting star, huh? What do we say? Huh? سهم الله في عدو الإيه؟ سهم الله في عدو الدين. We say that. The arrow of Allah is striking the enemy of the religion. يعني this is culture, so يعني there is no sunnah about it. طيب. الإيمان, another word, بمعنى التصديق. You attest, تصدق. And from it comes قول الله تعالى, what Allah said on the tongue of the children of Jacob, يعقوب عليه السلام, أولاد يعقوب, وما أنت بمؤمن لنا ولو كنا صادقين. أهو بمؤمن, بمؤمن يعني مصدق. يبقى إيمان also means what? To attest, to believe. To believe it's true. وكل هذه المعاني صحيحة. When you find the true faith, you find what? الأمن, صحيح؟ مش الإيمان, مش faith give you أمن؟ طمأنينة؟ ها؟ طيب. We got that? طب this is the definition linguistically. Are you ready to take the one technically? But write this line. I love this line. The meaning of Iman to know, to believe, and to be convinced beyond the least shadow of doubt. معنى الإيمان, to know, the knowledge that leads you to believe, and that belief convinces you that you have no doubt about what you believe in. Shall I say this again? To know. To know يعني, to know يعني. To know Allah, His names and attributes, His Lordship, what He did for you. To know about the books, the messengers, the Qadr, the Day of Resurrection. To know all these things, to learn it. To learn it first. So the entry to Iman is what? Knowledge. And that is why اقرأ, read. Read. Iman doesn't come like this, that you're going to just walk around and an angel comes is going to reveal to you the definition. You must learn what Iman is. To know, but knowledge that leads you to believe. If that knowledge doesn't lead you to Iman, to believe, then that knowledge is niqma. It's not good actually. It's better that you did not know. The problem that if you know and then you do not, ولذلك يقول لك ايه, هو why did the Jews earn the anger of Allah? Why? Because they know. They know. ده انت شوف شوف الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يعرفونه كما يعرفون أبناءه. They know it like they know their children. And one of them actually made that statement. ومعرفتي لمحمد أشد. والله I know. I believe it's Abdullah ibn Salam. I know that Muhammad brought the truth more than I'm certain about it. More than I'm certain about this child is mine. Why? Because at the end of the day, the only one who can confirm that for you is your wife, really. Allah al-musta'an. But I am more certain that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought the truth than my certainty regarding my son or my daughter. ومع هذا يكفر. وشوف انت يعني شوف انت ليه. I don't want to get off the subject because we have a curriculum to finish. You know the conversation that took place between the father of Safiya and her his brother. You recall something like this in the Sunnah? Safiya bint Huyay ibn Akhtab and his brother. يقول له أهو هو. Is he the one? One of them went to see the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to check whether he is the messenger who's written in the Torah or not. أهو هو 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 يقول لك هو تتبعه والله لو إيه حتى no I'm not gonna follow him يقول لك كده. فأنا عايز أقول لك إيه to know that leads to what believe otherwise you fall under that category you earn the wrath of Allah that Allah giving you the knowledge but that knowledge did not help you. And normally, I'm telling you, normally what will come between you, if you have the knowledge of something, and what will come between you and following that knowledge, one thing. You know what it is? What? Kibr. Arrogance. ما هو انت ازاي انت تحمل هذا الحديث لا يدخل الجنة. اسمع. لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. If you have the weight of an atom of pride in your heart, you will not enter Jannah. Why? Because that arrogance, that pride will come between you and submitting to what you know. إنهم كانوا إذا قيل لهم لا إله إلا الله ها what يستكبرون. When it was said to them to say لا إله إلا الله they are arrogant to say it. فهو you know to believe and to be convinced beyond the least shadow of doubt. هذا هو معنى الإيمان. Faith, write that line too. Faith, thus faith is, I'm not done yet. Thus faith is firm belief arising out of what? Out of what? لا اصحوا معايا يا إخوة أنا مش هشتغل كده على الفاضي. Arising out of what? Knowledge. I'm just saying it but in a different way. Huh? Thus faith is firm belief arising out of what? Knowledge and conviction. When you have faith on the basis of knowledge, you're a killer. You're a killer. ما أحد يحركك. No one can move you. When you have the belief in Allah, but in the basis of knowledge. ليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لك العالم أشد على الشيطان من ألف عابد. يعني القول هذا لا يصح للنبي يعني معذرة هو يصح موقوفا على ابن عباس. That a knowledgeable Muslim is harder on Shaitan than a thousand worshipper. Someone who is by the book in worshipping. عابد يعبد excels in عبادة but without knowledge. Shaitan can play with him. But I learned why? Because he has the knowledge, he has the hujjah. When a shubha presented to him, you know what a shubha is? A misconception. Presented to him, huh? He stands. I went and I visited, and I think I shared this with you before. An Arabic priest, Catholic. He's local here in Denver. He actually invited me to dinner in his house. I went. And as soon as I got there, you know what he got into? He got into the names and the attributes of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, he wanted to prove that Allah is a spirit that can go into other things. Imagine if you don't have the knowledge of that field and you're sitting in front of this guy. By the time you're done with dinner, you're probably going to do... Seriously, that's a serious business. And I know a lot of you are longing to bring Islam to Christian and Jews, but I call upon you to learn your deen first, learn your aqidah first. Don't go there, because if you get into, if somebody gets you who really knows his business and he knows where to get you, he got me الفرابي ومش عارف ايه. قلت له بقول لك ايه الفرابي دول صوفية. فيلم الفرابي ده معتزلة وصوفية من الاخر كده. Let's talk about the mainstream Muslims. What do we believe? What do we believe? Allah has a divine essence. Okay? He has a divine essence. Allah is not a spirit. I don't believe in what people believe وحدة الوجود والكلام هذا. I don't believe in that. And this is not true. It's not supported by evidence. Right there. حجة. الشاهد يعني. طيب. يا إخوة. Listen carefully. الإيمان. Oh, here is the technical definition now. All of this was like my little... No. This is my little ijtihad. يعني. I just wanted... But here is the technical definition, which you will find it in the books. Faith is a compound of the following elements. Or we can say, faith is قول وعمل يزيد وينقص. You as a student of knowledge, even so you're not an Arabic speaking, you should memorize that line. الإيمان قول وعمل يزيد وينقص. Right here. تقول الكلمة دي لواحد يقول اوه man. Shy away from this guy. This guy knows his stuff. You didn't even have to tell him the details. Faith is saying action increases and decreases. Of course, we're going to detail that so you understand the essence of that. Iman, qawl, saying, amal, and amal, an action increases and decreases. That's another definition. That's another way. Here is another definition. يعني that's also a famous one. And I shared it with you before, I think. اعتقاد بالجنان. If you want to use this one too, that's beautiful. اعتقاد بالجنان. إيمان is اعتقاد بالجنان. الجنان اللي هو إيه؟ القلب. Firm belief in the heart. قول باللسان. And you pronounce this with your tongue. You say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله, وعمل بالجوارح والأركان, and acting upon this with your physical. That would include your heart, would include your tongue, would include your limbs. Increases and decreases. Are we okay so far? Here is the piece which confuses all of you. And it shouldn't be. I don't know why it's confusing to you, but it shouldn't be confusing. But I don't know. You guys got to tell me why it's confusing to you. قول, saying. The saying of the heart and the tongue. We said faith is what? قول and saying and no, saying and action. Iman is saying and action. Under saying comes the saying or the statement of the heart and the statement of the tongue. Just write this down. Under action comes the action of the heart and the action of the body, the limbs. Four components. There are four components which make those two words, saying and action. قول, عمل. قول القلب, قول اللسان, عمل القلب, عمل الجوارح. Shall we go over each one of those quickly? What do you mean by the statement of the heart? Listen. To know and to believe. Is that difficult? Is that difficult? To know and to believe. To know what? To learn Tawheed, Tawheed al-Uluhiyya, Tawheed al-Asma' wa Sifat, Tawheed al-Rububiyya, Tawheed al-Uluhiyya. To know about the hereafter. But again, that knowledge leads you to what? To attest and believe. اتصدق وتؤمن. So this is the statement of the heart. This heart knows who Allah is. This heart attests inside your heart كده الله هو الخالق هو الرازق. Attest to that. You call this the state, but so far did the heart work? I'm asking you, so far did the heart work? No, it did not. That's why we separated the two. You see, the action later on, we say the action of the heart. Now this knowledge drive the heart to work. Niyyah comes in sincerity, tawakkul, reliance, love, hubb Allah, hope in Allah. This is the work of the heart. So you know the difference now between the statement of the heart and the work of the heart? The statement is pure knowledge. And being sure about that knowledge, that's it. But so far you have not worked. Now as a result of that knowledge, comes in al-azima, the commitment. You know what? This is so true, man. I'm going to commit myself to that knowledge. Allah made me, He created me, and He wants me to worship Him. I have to pray 5 times. Now the niyyah, the intention, let me go to the masjid to pray. And now this must be sincere. What about my job? Tawakkul, rely on Allah. Maybe my salah is not going to be accepted. I hope in Allah. But maybe in my way to the masjid, somebody is going to shoot me. No, I'm going to fear Allah. Oh, amal al-qalba. You're getting it? So the saying of the heart mobilizes the heart to do what? To love Allah, rely upon Allah, tawakkul ala Allah, love of Allah, hope in Allah, fear for Allah, having sincerity to do things for Allah. So this is the work of the heart. إنما الأعمال بالنية. We're getting this? Now the saying of the tongue is what? الشهادتين. Attesting, testifying. قوم كده, you stand in front of the people, say أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. طب the action of the rest of the limbs. الصلاة, صدقة, last night, جزاكم الله خيرا. ها؟ اه your body works. Lowering your gaze. Joining good, forbidding evil. هذا هو الإيمان, those four things. إيمان, الإيمان, again, الإيمان, قول وعمل, faith, إيمان, is saying an action. Under saying comes the saying of the heart, the statement of the heart, and the saying of the tongue. Under action comes in the action of the heart and the action of. Is that difficult? Assalamu alaikum. Is it difficult? It is easy. And it really helps you understand what Iman is. وهذا تعريف أهل السنة والجماعة للإيمان. And this is the definition of أهل السنة والجماعة to Iman. There is a consensus. Now, if you define Iman differently, you're wrong. Because you went away from what? Al-Ijma'. لأن الإجماع حجة في العقيدة. Remember when we talk about the sources of our Aqidah, what are the sources of our Aqidah? What was the sources of our Aqidah? Quran, Sunnah, Ijma'. Now the Sahaba and the Tabi'een have consensus regarding this definition. Now, if you define Iman different, you're contradicting the best generation. You're making up your own definition of Iman. Consensus. And consensus when they agree upon something. But now, you can't just say consensus without saying who said there was a consensus, correct? Scholarly consensus is not masses. The scholars had a consensus. And also, where do we find that consensus? اسمع الإمام البغوي رحمه الله من أئمة السنة يقول اتفقت الصحابة والتابعون ومن بعدهم من علماء السنة أن الأعمال من الإيمان وقالوا إن الإيمان قول وعمل وعقيدة. No. يعني فحوى الكلام what I said, the definition of إيمان. الإمام البغوي. الشافعي رحمه الله says في كتابه الأم إجماع الصحابة والتابعين ومن بعدهم على أن الإيمان قول وعمل ونية. نفس الكلام. Faith is action, saying, and intention. And I shared with you the statement of Imam al-Bukhari, which is compiled with Al-Lalakai, rahimahullah. طيب. الفرق. The worst of them, here is a sect, 100% astray from that definition. They are called Al-Khawarij. And Al-Khawarij is a sect that emerged at the time of Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله عنه وهم الذين خرجوا على علي. They objected Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib because he accepted the arbitration. موضوع يعني we don't want to dig in there. What is the issue of how they define iman, those people? Remember I said faith is a compound of four components. They said faith is a solid entity. If you touch it, you are a disbeliever. You commit a major sin, you are a disbeliever. شايف ما هو I want to tell you how the ummah differed right here. ما هو إيه؟ إحنا بنقول الإيمان. Faith is what? Four components. Inshallah, the next lecture is very important. We're going to tell you that there are إيمان واجب. You cannot lose some of these components. There is a minimum that you must have. Below that minimum, yes, you disbelieve in Islam. But these Khawarij, they said that if you commit a major sin, you are a disbeliever, you're not a believer anymore, and you stay in hell for eternity. لا تخرج من النار. وما فيش حاجة بس بيزيد وينقص. There is nothing called increases and decreases. This is the worst. Again, I don't want to dig deep into their evidence and how to refute it. Enough to know this. In your book, actually, there is enough work that you can find to read about the subject. They used evidence. الآيات اللي هي إيه؟ طيب أنت بتقول لي يعني here is يعني for the sake of argument. Here it is. يقول لك إيه؟ ومن يقتل مؤمنا متعمدا فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها وغضب الله عليه ولعنه وأعد له جهنم وساءت مصير. If you kill a believer intentionally and you're a Muslim and you killed another Muslim, basically you stay in hell for eternity based on that verse. If you take that verse only without any other A, ما هو if you want to investigate and study an issue in the religion, you must compile all the texts that talk about the issue and sort it out. هات المقيد على المطلق على العام مخصص والمجمل وموضوع كده ايه موضوع اصول فقه. You compile all the hadith together and then what? This one is general, this one is specific, this one in a certain case, this one, and you sort out everything. لا هم بقوا عليه ما هو these sects what they do, they take one evidence like this and they build the whole thing on it. This is exactly the statement taking things out of what? Context. طب هنا الآية في سورة النساء, the verse in سورة النساء tells you that if a Muslim kills another Muslim, huh, he will stay in hell for eternity. طيب. In the day of resurrection, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take out the people who committed major sins after they spend some time in hell. We know this for a fact. So how you reconcile the two? The verse says that he will stay in hell for eternity, and the hadith says that they will come out of hell. شوف اف احفظ هذه القاعدة ممرايز ترد عليها على أي خارجي, أي واحد يكفر البني آدمين ترد عليه. شوف إذا وعد الله سبحانه وتعالى فهو موفي لا محالة, وإذا أوعد فهو بالخيار. If Allah promises something, Allah will fulfill. If He tells you, if you come to the masjid and attend a lecture like this, your sins are forgiven, done. You will get that reward, done. If Allah promises a reward, You're getting that reward. Why? ليه؟ لأن إخلاف الوعد نقص. Breaking the promise is a mark of imperfection. And Allah is above. Huh? Even in our human level, when I promise you something and I don't fulfill it, huh? Come on, you promised. صحيح؟ في نقص. There is Allah is above that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala awad, if Allah threatens that if you kill another Muslim, you'll stay in hell for eternity, it's up to Allah to make this happen or to let go. يريحك خالص هذه القاعدة. وردت هذه يعني أظنها في مسند أبي يعلى. قول يعني نسبت للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. That if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this killer of another Muslim will stay in hell for eternity, I still say that he's under the will of Allah. واقع تحت المشيئة. Allah could pardon him. And Allah could make this happen. ما هو اللي رايحك برضه what gave you a break. ومن عقيدتنا and one of the principles of our beliefs ألا نقطع لأحد بجنة ولا بنار. That I do not say this person is going to Jannah for eternity. I don't sit here and distribute Jannah and hell. It's not my business. It's not my business. وتذكرون يا إخوة لما كان عندنا جنازة الصبي الصبيان نسأل الله أن يرحم آبائهم. The two boys from Burma. What did I say to you? ماذا قلت لكم؟ قلت يا إخوة في الجنازة بندعو للآباء. ما هو في أربع تكبيرات four تكبيرات. These boys are under the age of puberty. Normally in the third تكبيرة we make dua for who? But we know that the children of the Muslims who die before the age of puberty, they go to Jannah. And guess who takes care of them until their parents come and take them over? Ibrahim alayhi salam. So we end up making dua for who? For the parents, that Allah grant them steadfastness. But remember, you cannot say those two boys are going to Jannah. You can't. اتعين. وفي حديث في سنن النسائي الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم attended a funeral of a little boy and when he returned عائشة رضي الله عنها made that statement. طوبى له. How lucky he is. Little boy. عصفور من عصافير الجنة. He's gonna be a bird in Jannah. قال وما يدريك. How do you know? إن غلام الخضر طبع كافرا. The little boy in the story في الخضر. وأما الغلام فكان أبواه مؤمنين فخشينا غلامه طبع ايه صحيح فلا تقطع. فالخوارج بقى ايه هيشتغل. ما هو انت ما هو listen, if you're gonna use that rule that you see somebody committing a major sin, خلاص انت كافر وانت رايح النار. ده ليلة بيضة دي, ده احنا هنقتل في بعض. وبعدين انت عندك مشكلة تانية عقدية عجيبة. يعني you have another big problem regarding this subject, that if you commit a major sin you're done. That means the earth will be filled with crisis. You know hadith قاتل الماء, the person who killed 100 souls. You remember what happened? He went to the number 99. He went the first one, right? Huh? Again a worshipper, somebody who did not know his stuff, he did not have the knowledge of the deen. Listen, I killed 99 souls, do I have a chance? What did he say to him? Oh, خارج هذا, the فكر الخوارج. قال له إيه? What did he say to him? طب what did he do? طب imagine now if anybody commits a major sin, he's كافر خلاص. If I'm كافر خلاص, no chance to come back. ها ده التوبة هذه, this توبة, سبحان الله, that repentance, والله earth is filled with goodness because of people who return to Allah. I'm telling you, the majority of the work of Islam is done now by people who came back from darkness, from major sins. أنا أقول لك الإنسان فأنت الآن هتشتغل because he committed a major sin, يخرج من الملة وخلاص وكافر, مشكلة كبيرة هذه, big problem. Big problem. فالفكر هذا again, but I want to show you it originates from where? From تعريف الإيمان. الصحابة, التابعين, the companions and their students, they say faith, actions and saying increases and decreases, and then you come with your bid'ah, then you come with your definition and say no, iman is solid, does not increase or decrease. Different definition. And on that basis, you start messing around the Muslims. تكفر الناس وتخرج الناس من الملة وشغلان. Again, I want to stress the fact that we have ways to label somebody to be a kafir. Listen, in Islam, not everybody, we're going to go to al-irja', al-murji'ah now. We're going to talk about al-murji'ah. I don't know if time is going to allow us or not again. Allahu al-musta'an. What time now? We just warm up. Huh? We're going to go to al-irja' in a minute. Al-irja' dul galu if you say la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, and if you know in your heart and you intend to do stuff, you don't have to pray. You don't have to fast. The total contrary of this. But we are balanced. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we're balanced. We still can label somebody to be a kafir, but with what? With disciplines. We are disciplined. How? الأول, somebody who does not pray, for example. هل هو منكر للأمر? Is he denying the command? If he is denying the command, يكفر. أنا أقول لك كافر. بس let a scholar do it. Not the general public. تسأله كده يا أخي, brother, my brother in Islam, I love you Allah for the sake of Allah, how come you do not pray 5 times a day? والله يا شيخ, I don't think we should be praying. Why? I'm too busy. And this salah should be only for the people 1400 years ago. They used to ride camels and donkey and mules. They had more time. شوف هذا يكفر. هذا هو. بس let a scholar teach him first, establish the evidence against him, and label him. As long as you are not denying the command. Ramadan, يا أخي, ما شاء الله, أنت healthy وصحتك حلوة, وليه ما بتصومش? Why I starve myself to death? For what? For what? To do what? Starve myself to death. Why? I'm not going to do it. في القرآن يقول مالي مالش دعوة في القرآن. We heard somebody say, you want me to pay 70,000 Egyptian pounds, this is an Egyptian for you, to go and kiss Iraq in Mecca? No, I'm not going to do that. قصد الحجر الأسود يعني. منكر. هذا كلام. But first let him know that هذا الكلام كلام كفار. يخرج من الملة. This is important. The other end of it is istihlal. You see, once it comes to the commands, do pray, do fast, you cannot deny. Look at this now. Somebody who doesn't pray. Here is another perfect scenario. Someone who does not pray. And we said this before. يا brother, ليه ما بتصليش يا أخي? أستغفر الله يا شيخ. والله يا شيخ, أنا بحاول. I'm trying, والله. I know the salah and I'm working hard, but inshallah, make dua for me, Sheikh. لا, هذا لا يكفر. لو. Leave him. Yeah. طبعا الموضوع في كلام يعني in depth يعني. It's not the place for it to discuss. But the other end of it, the unlawful. استحلال المعصية that you do not make the unlawful lawful. إذا استحللت الحرام تكفر. If you make the حرام حلال for you تكفر. Someone who drinks يعني the alcohol يعني. You ask him يا أخي ليه بتشرب؟ It's not حرام. هذا بيخرج من الملة هذا. ازاي يا عم وانت عندك نص؟ ولا لا لا ازنات حرام. طب you're having a girlfriend. It's okay. It's lawful. هذا يكفر. بس again you must establish the evidence and let a scholar do it. I just want to invite your mind to also we have manners and etiquettes to actually conclude that this person can go out of the fold of Islam. But we're very disciplined and we must use the methodology to do so. I guess with this, inshallah, I will see you on Wednesday, بإذن الله تعالى. We will discuss الإرجاء and الكرامية and الماتوردية وخاصة إخوة موضوع يعني a very sensitive subject اللي هو يعني إرجاء الفقهاء ومسألة الأحناف and their view regarding الإيمان وإخراج العمل من مسمى الإيمان and so forth. إن شاء الله we'll discuss this بإذن الله تعالى next lecture which is going to be on Wednesday. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك، والحمد لله رب العالمين.